Hi, I'm Ethan Connor, Technical Engagement Engineer at Grape City Developer Solutions. In this video, we will demonstrate data binding in ActiveReports. We'll cover how to use a stored procedure as a data set, as well as binding to a generic SQL data table. We're going to show data binding using the End User Designer. The End User Designer can be launched by going to Start, Grape City, and selecting ActiveReports 12 Designer. First, with the End User Designer open, we'll add a data source connection. We'll use MySQL Server on the local machine and bind to the Northwind database. Next, we'll add a dataset connection, and we'll call the Customer Details Stored Procedure. I'll rename this dataset so I don't confuse it with the second dataset I will be adding later for the parameter. We need to make sure the command type is set to Stored Procedure. As you can see, the Stored Procedure pulls certain fields from the customer's data table and filters it by a city parameter. For now, we'll pass a specific city value directly to the stored procedure for testing purposes. We're going to add a table to the design surface to display the data from the stored procedure. Next, we want the user to be able to pick a city from a list and pass that to a stored procedure. To do this, we'll first create another dataset specifically for that parameter. We'll get distinct cities from the customer's data table. Validate it. Then, we'll add a parameter to the report. Name it CityParam and pass the ParamDS dataset we just created as the available values to populate the dropdown for this parameter. This process will prompt the user to select a city. Now, we need to pass that selection to the stored procedure to filter the dataset. To do so, we will go back and edit the stored procedure dataset and change the city parameter value to the value the user selects. We'll change the value field to the parameter the user would have selected. As you can see, the report filters based on the parameter we select. Moving on to binding to a generic SQL table, I have a pre-made report file with a grouped table. Let's establish a connection to my local instance of SQL Server and the AdventureWorks database. Now, we can add a dataset, and I'll use one of my existing queries from my notes to select every record from the products table that has a thumbnail image of the product. Let's preview the report and switch to galley mode to better view all columns. Note, we're not showing the use of parameters in this instance, but you can find a more detailed discussion of parameters in the Parameterized Reports video. All of these enhancements and more are available at grapecity.com. Be sure to tune into our blogs in the coming weeks, as we'll be offering more detail on product features. You can get the newest version of ActiveReports by downloading from the site today. Thanks for watching, and see you soon.